Hello students, let's start for the first period of lesson number 5, operation on rational numbers. We have discussed about rational numbers. Okay, we have discussed about rational numbers. What exactly are rational numbers? The numbers written in the form of numerator and denominator. Only when denominator is not zero, then the particular number is called as a rational numbers. In general, in other way, we can say it as fractions also. First, we will discuss about addition. Operation on rational numbers has four different points: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. And at the end, we will discuss about multiplicative inverse also. Now we shall discuss about addition. I have written four examples here. The first example is 4 upon 5 plus 7 upon 5. As the denominators are same, so we can add it directly. So I have taken your common 5. 4 plus 7 is written on the place of numerator. 4 plus 7 gives you 11 upon 5. So this is the answer of 4 upon 5 plus 7 upon 5 gives you 11 upon 5. Let's turn to second example. 8 upon 3 plus 9 upon 4. In this example, comparing this first example and second example, you observe a difference of, in first example, the denominators were same, and in second example, the denominators are not same. So what we have to do first? We have to make their denominators same. To do the denominators same, we have to multiply the denominators to the opposite side. Yes, so this 4 is multiplied up and down to the left side, and this 3 is multiplied up and down to the right side. Considering 8 into 4 upon 3 into 4 plus 9 into 3 upon 4 into 3. 8, 3, 9 and 4, students, they are kept same. Only the multiplication is done of 4 and 3 to make the denominators equal. Now, 8 4s are gives you 32. 9 3s are gives you 27. And 3 4s are 12. 4 3s are 12. Therefore, the denominator becomes equal. And finally, we have taken the denominator 12 here as a common number. So, 32 plus 27 gives you 59 upon 12. Got it, children? I hope you are understanding. Next, subtraction. First example, 8 upon 9 minus 6 upon 9. Same like addition, subtraction behaves for the like denominators and for the unlike denominators. What are like denominators? They are same numbers, and unlike denominators are not same denominators. 8 upon 9 minus 6 upon 9, denominator is same, so it is taken common here. So 8 minus 6 gives you 2 upon 9. Second example, 5 upon 4 plus 7 upon 6. The denominators are unequal here, therefore we are trying to make the denominators equal. Multiplying 6 to the left side both up and down, and multiplying 4 to the right side both up and down. 5 6 are 30, 7 4 are 28, 6 4 are 24, 4 6 are 24. So commonly taken here 24. 30 plus 28 gives you 58 upon 24. Then multiplication, our third operation is multiplication. We have finished addition and subtraction. First example, 4 upon 8 multiplied by 5 upon 3. Now students, you don't have to worry for multiplication, whether to make the denominators equal or not. You just have to multiply the numerator by numerator and multiply denominator by denominator. So 4 multiplied by 5, 4 5s are 20. And 8 multiplied by 3, 8 3s are gives you 24. So this is your final answer. Let's turn to second example. 7 multiplied by 6 gives you 42. 12 multiplied by 3 gives you 36. Your answer is 42 upon 36. Division. Fourth operation, division. 5 upon 7 divided by 9 upon 3. Students, remember always, if there is a division sign here, instead of dividing and making the sum complicated, convert the division sign to multiplication sign, and this number, right side number, will get converted upside down. So 9 upon 3 gets converted to 3 upon 9. Okay, 9 upon 3 gets converted to 3 upon 9. 5 upon 7 is written same. 5 upon 7, division sign converted to multiplication sign, and 9 upon 3 gets converted to 3 upon 9. Now you can multiply numerator by numerator and denominator by denominator. 5 into 3 written on the place of numerator, 7 into 9 written in the place of denominator. 5 3s are is 15, 7 9s are gives you 63. So the answer of 5 upon 7 divided by 9 upon 3 gives you 15 upon 63. Second example. Same we will do. We don't have to worry much. Only when you convert the division sign to multiplication sign, you have to convert the right side part, right side fraction, upside down. So this 8 upon 5 is done as 5 upon 8. This is the multiplicative inverse. We'll study it in the next slide. 6 upon 3 is written same. 6 upon 3 multiplied by upside down of 8 upon 5 is 5 upon 8. Now 6 multiplied by 5 written on the place of numerator. 8 into 3 written in the place of denominator. So 6 5s are 30. 8 3s are 24. So the final answer of this example, 6 upon 3 divided by 8 upon 5 is equal to 30 upon 24. Let's study about the multiplicative inverse. In the first example, I have written the example 4 upon 3. Multiplicative inverse is nothing but upside down of the given fraction. So 4 upon 3 gets converted to 3 upon 4. Okay, but you cannot write 4 upon 3 is equal to 3 upon 4. Very sorry, example is wrong. You will get 0 marks here if you write straight away like this. You cannot write like this. You have to write down in sentence formation so that the concept is clear for you as well as you understand it very well. Okay, so the multiplicative inverse of 4 upon 3 is 3 upon 4. Same way, second example, 9 upon 16 is the example, and you have to find out the multiplicative inverse of it. So the multiplicative inverse of 9 upon 16 is 16 upon 9. Just to do multiplicative inverse. I hope you understand the today's example. Thank you.